नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग एंड वेलकम। टुडे दिस प्रोग्राम हैज बीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय कला भारती एंड सेंटर फॉर द स्टडी ऑफ सोसाइटी एंड सेक्युलरिज्म विथ सम एक्टिव असिस्टेंस फ्रॉम ख्याल ट्रस्ट जोन फिल्मन मुंबई अबाउट होम we will tell you a little later in the program. And Neela Bhagwat of the Gwalior Gharana is going to perform morning ragas. We will give a warm welcome to her. In Europe and America, most important to a place which is now notorious for bomb blast every day, that is Peshawar. And she has stuck to the Gwalior Gharana idiom tradition, a pupil of Pandit Charachandra Arolkar and Jal Balakodia. But she has also made many innovative experiments through that idiom and compose a new bandishes which are feminist in content. She has reinterpreted Kabir, Meera, Marathi, Sen poets like Tukaram, Sukhameda, then Bahinabai, many others. She will be accompanied on the tabla by Anutosh Degharia. We have promised Anutosh that 12:30 we will finish the program because he has to catch 1 o'clock train at Dadar station. He will be going to Hyderabad to accompany Pandit Arvind Parikh. So, you know the schedule of the program. On the Sarangi is Sandeep Mishra. People say that North Indians should not come to Bombay and we don't agree with them. Because if North Indians don't come, then Sanjit will not come. And how will we have Sarangi here? Because there are very few Sarangi players in Bombay. And I am very glad that people like Ram Narayan, Pandit Ram Narayan, who left Lahore and Delhi and came to Bombay, settled here. Like that, Sanjit is also from Banaras, but is very much welcome in Bombay. On the Tanpura is Jayant Naidu and Kanakavalli. She is a pupil of Neela Bhagwat. I request Neela Bhagwat to start her recital. She will begin with the rag Miyan Ki Todi. Dhanyavad.
The Nayikas in classical forms. Joan and Vinod both have been very fond of classical Indian bandishes and ragas and all of that. लाल मनावन मैं चली समझत नाही काहू की बात हूँ तोरे कारण व्याकुल भई प्यारे तू चल उठ मोरे साथ.
Oh. Yeah.
Music has come from the bhakti tradition, so Neela performed
what is called confluence of bhakti and Sufi tradition. So thank you very much. This is a short, there is no break, but I will request Aishwarya Murthy to come to the stage, and all of those who have come to this program and those who have known about this program, they have often inquired, who is Joan Feldman Mumbai? So we thought that we must give a proper introduction to the person in whose memory this program is being held. So I request Aishwarya Murthy to come to the stage and tell us about Joan Feldman Mumbai.
In Philadelphia. In 1944, after having been drafted into the army and completing his basic training, Cyrus was sent to Oak Ridge, Tennessee to work on the Manhattan Project due to his expertise as an analytical chemist. In the April of 1945, when the families of the Manhattan Project workers were allowed to come to Oak Ridge, Rose and Joan joined Cyrus there. Like many of the people sent to Oak Ridge to work on the Manhattan Project, Cyrus and his growing family fell in love with East Tennessee and remained in Oak Ridge for many years. While growing up, Joan attended the Cedar Hill Elementary School, Jefferson Junior High School, and Oak Ridge School. She then went on to attend the Brandeis University in Boston, where she received a degree in fine arts. It was there that she met her future husband, Vinod Mumbai. The two married in a traditional Indian ceremony in New Delhi in 1969 and later moved to Bombay, where they lived for several years. Having learnt Hindi and Bengali before she moved to India, Joan participated fully in the cultural life of Bombay, attending Indian classical music programs, watching her favorite Bollywood movies, and writing for leading magazines and newspapers on a number of cultural topics. As a young woman, Joan was known not only for her many talents, but for her beauty, her sharp wit, and her delightful and contagious laugh. Early in her life, she demonstrated her talent as an artist, musician, and a linguist. As an artist, she was greatly influenced by the German Expressionist movement, epitomized by the artist Kathy Kollwitz, and by the cultural icons of the Weimar era, such as Bertolt Brecht in literature and drama, Peter Lorre and Marlene Dietrich in film, and Kurt Weill and Hans Eisler in music. Her paintings and drawings were displayed at several art shows in New York City in the late 1970s and the early 1980s, and she also designed several book jackets for the Oxford University Press while living in India. She was an accomplished pianist and played the flute in the Oak Ridge Symphony Orchestra. She was fluent in Hindi, Bengali, French, and German. Unfortunately, Joan suffered a mental breakdown in 1973 while she and her husband were living in India. The couple returned to the US in 1974, where Joan struggled with mental problems for most of her life. During the decade that followed her initial breakdown, Joan periodically recovered well enough to practice her art, but in later years was unable to do so. Joan was diagnosed with cancer in 2004, but she refused treatment despite the urging of her family. Throughout her adult life, but particularly during her final years, she was loved by all of her caregivers for her delightful personality and her mischievous sense of humor, traits that stayed with her until the end. Joan is survived by her son Sunil, her former husband Vinod, who has remained devoted to her throughout the years and will always be a beloved member of the family, her mother Rose Feldman, her brothers Henry, Ben, Robert, and her sister Alice.
A round of applause for the memory of Joan. I am very glad to announce that Sri Vinod Mumbai has assured us that every year at least one concert will be held during this time at Karnataka Sang in collaboration with Kala Bharati. So all of you are requested to give another round of applause for Vinod Mumbai. Now I request Nila Bhagwat to carry on with her recital. I want to come to the stage to announce, make the announcements about for this one very good decision which he has taken, that he will support, I mean the family will support a poor student of music who wants to learn Hindustani music in memory of Joan Feldman Mumbai.
Dear friends and comrades, although I want to speak in Hindi, but this program is being recorded also for Joan's mother, who is 87 now, who has made a generous donation, which will be used for the purpose that Nandu just described. I'm very glad to see all of you, and I'm very deeply appreciative of the efforts that Khayal Trust, in particular our old friend Neela and her husband Nandu and all of you have put to make this program possible. And in particular, I remembered all the times that we would go almost 40 years now to Dalan Music Circle, stay till late night, catch the number one bus from Mahim or from other places, the last bus which would leave around 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock, all the way back to the Kulaba post office where we used to live. And we enjoyed our time then, and of course it's sad that while we mourn her passing, we would like to also celebrate her life and perhaps do it in a fitting way by offering this scholarships. And the first scholarship, has the first person who has been selected, is a promising young artist, Ms. Kumutni Gajanan Kohli, has been selected to receive the first award as part of the Joan Feldman Mumbai Memorial Award. And we hope to give further awards in the coming years, and as Nandu just said, hope to have one concert or even more if possible every year in memory of my late wife. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vinod. Thank you very much. Kumudini Kohli, she is participating in a music competition today, and she will finish her singing in that competition and is expected to be here by 12 o'clock. So we will hand over the scholarship, first installment of the scholarship to her as soon as she comes here. And now we go ahead with the remaining part of the program. I request Neela Bhagwat to sing the second rag, which is, I believe, is the Dausaran. Thank you very much.